Welcome back to KC Talks EV. So as I mentioned in the previous video, this video is going to be the charging curve test and range test of the MG5 Long Range. So this car, compared to the previous generation, has a total battery capacity of 61.1 kilowatt hours versus 52.5 kilowatt hours in the previous generation, and hopefully a usable capacity of 57.7 kilowatt hours versus 48.8 kilowatt hours of the previous generation. That should mean a significant range increase, and as a result, I have modified the route slightly. So what we're going to be going, or where we're going to be going, is we're going to be doing here to Birstall and back, but actually we're going to be doing that again in order to increase the amount of mileage covered. Hopefully that should give us a better available capacity calculated, and also give me a better indication of things like total range. So again, I've reset both trip computers just to make sure. I'm going to reset them now. Similar process to the previous generation, and also a similar process to the ZS EV. One thing I will mention, however, is I've tried to get this car to charge at, well, up to 100%. Unfortunately, it hasn't worked. I have a feeling it might be because I'm charging at such a high state of charge with a rapid charger. I highly recommend that you do not do this anyway. In terms of weather conditions, we're looking at 12 degrees Celsius, so very similar conditions actually to what we had for the previous generation. So hopefully it will be a very informative test. And finally, we're looking at a mild headwind of about 13 miles per hour. That means that unfortunately on the way back to Birstall / Morley, there is going to be a headwind that isn't cancelled out by the fact I'm coming back. But hopefully it won't distort the results too much, and certainly won't distort the results as much as, for example, doing a larger distance on the M62. The M62, if you don't already know, that point past sort of Huddersfield, Brighouse, up to Rochdale and Manchester, that bit is one of the highest elevation motorways in the UK, and I don't really want 382 metres of additional elevation affecting my results. One last thing that I completely forgot to mention was actually the test sort of parameters. So for example, I will be using MG Pilot. This car has MG Pilot, so I'll be sticking that as close to 70 miles an hour as I can. Now, to be completely honest, there is a 40 mile an hour speed limit restriction from the A63 up until the M62, but hopefully that won't distort the results too much. Anyway, let's get started. Okay, so I've just done 57.2 miles, average speed of 60 miles per hour. I've taken about 55 minutes in order to do that. It doesn't give me the exact time, and I've done 2.9 miles per kilowatt hour. Now, to increase my average speed, my plan of action is to get back onto the motorway, but I'm planning on going straight through the M62, but then once I get to the North Cave where the M62 turns to the A63, I'm going to come off the motorway and come back on it again. So hopefully I should be able to increase my average speed quite significantly. Luckily, I haven't actually reached any congestion, although I will say, however, that I think the weather is definitely about to turn, which could be interesting for the range. So I've arrived with 63% remaining, so I've used approximately 34% in order to get here. So hopefully it should balance out quite nicely. So anyway, let's carry on. Okay, so I've just come off at North Cave. I've done 100.7 miles, average speed of 61 miles per hour, 1.6 hours and 3.2 miles per kilowatt hour. So yes, as you can tell, the efficiency definitely has increased compared to what it was on the way there. Now, the problem that I'm gonna have is, I have a feeling that because I've reduced the mileage, this could be very interesting when it actually comes to the total mileage. What I might have to do is I might have to actually go a slightly different way in order to extend the mileage and get to a fairly low state of charge. So I've arrived here with 43%, and I'm about to do another 40 miles to get it to around 140, 150 miles. Another thing that I've also done is the decibel test. So the maximum decibels I have reached at 70 miles an hour is 73.1 decibels. So I haven't really got too many points of comparison. I'm gonna try my ZS EV when I have some time on the similar stretch of road. But I think at the moment we do have I thought I'd just update you on the, I guess the two-thirds point, halfway point, depending on whatever you think. Okay, so I've just completed the range test of the MG5 long range. So I've done 152.8 miles, average speed of 60 miles per hour. It's taken me roughly 2.5 hours to do that, and I've averaged 3.1 miles per kilowatt hour in efficiency. I will put the metric conversions down here. So if we extrapolate the results, a total theoretical 100% down to 0% range is 177.8 miles. I probably should also mention that I arrived here with 11%, but I think it just was on the borderline, so it's just ticked down to 10%. And if you then extrapolate the total available capacity, you're looking at a total available capacity of 57.35 kilowatt hours. That is very close to what MG quotes, which is 57.7 kilowatt hours, and it is a increase from the previous generation MG5 of around 48.8 kilowatt hours. Now, I probably should mention from my previous testing that my available capacity, I think, was quite wrong. That was purely because of the fact that it was basically a brand new car. This car had done around 2,500 miles before I picked it up, and I've somehow managed to do about 500 miles and I'm still in Leeds, so I'm about to put on some more miles here. But hopefully that demonstrates that yes, this car definitely has a larger battery pack and larger available capacity compared to the previous generation. In terms of the actual testing itself, I did hit a little bit of rain towards the end of the test, as well as that headwind was definitely noticeable. So I might have got this just on the previous footage about the total range, but the current journey here and the current journey back towards Hull had a marked noticeable decrease in terms of efficiency going to Leeds. That is also primarily because of the elevation change. There is a slight elevation change going from sea level or close to sea level in Hull up to Leeds, but normally that would have been cancelled out by the time I got back, but obviously I took a slightly different route. So you do have to take that into account, but looking at that, the total theoretical capacity or total theoretical usable capacity is increased as well as the range has increased. So anyway, let's move on to the charging test. So as I said previously, we are starting from a state of charge of 10%. So I've just plugged in. We are currently getting 349 volts at 124 amps. So unlike some other previous tests, I can actually use a bit of a time-lapse function in order to show you this, because the MG5 does show voltage and current draw. So yes, we've started off from a state of charge of 10% and 350 volts multiplied by 124 is approximately 43.4 kilowatts. So let's carry on with the test. I'm going to take this around to 90% state of charge in order to show you the charging curve over time. Okay, so that was put to a stop too fairly quickly because the camera decided to fall off the windscreen. So at the moment we're on 24%. We're still taking the full rate of charge, so 358 volts at 124 amps. So that's after the first 10 minutes. I'll probably check up on the next 20 minutes. Okay, so 21 minutes in, we are at 37%. So we're taking 361 volts at 115 amps. Okay, so we have just ticked over 47%, 366 volts at 114 amps at the half an hour mark. So let's see how it goes from here. Things aren't going too well for me today. My camera app has decided to also break, so I'm currently using the built-in phone's camera app. So we are on 59% after 40 minutes. We are getting 375 volts at 113 amps. So we've just reached 50 minutes on this charging curve test. So we have got 70% state of charge. Voltage is 387 volts at 113 amps. Okay, so we've just come up to 60 minutes or an hour. We have now reached 81, 82%, I think it's just ticked over. And the voltage is 400 volts at 112 amps. So interestingly, that is very close to what MG have explicitly put on their website. So that is, I think, 61 minutes from 10 to 80%. So it is very close, and we are definitely getting what MG are quoting. So what will be the next interesting point is to see where it throttles. Now, the ZS EV in particular throttles around now close to 90%. So I am going to take it slightly higher than 90% to see where it throttles. But I have a feeling that I haven't actually looked exactly where it does, but let's find out. So just another thing here is the charging situation. So we're at 83% and it is currently at 84 amps and 400 volt. It will be very interesting to see where the next cutoff point will be, or is it just going to now slowly tail down? So we've now reached 88% state of charge. We're very close to an hour and 10 minutes. I think it's actually an hour and 8 minutes exactly. And as you can tell, we're at 403 volts at 61 amps. So at the moment, what I'm expecting is something very similar to the ZS EV, in which that the current starts to drop off like a stone past 90%. So that is pretty much, I think, the end of the charging test. So what I'll probably do at this point in time is I'll let it run for a little bit longer to see where it sort of tails off, and finally we'll conclude. Okay, so we have just reached 90% state of charge. We have now dropped the current down to around 44, 45 amps, which essentially means a charging speed of around 16 kilowatt. At this point in time, I definitely would have stopped charging by this point. So I think the best thing to do now is to unplug and conclude this video. So to conclude the charging test, we went from 10% up to 90% in an approximately an hour and 10 minutes. I'll also put a table here with the times and the charging speed and the state of charge. So this definitely is concordant with what MG Motor UK say. So they say approximately 10 to 80% rapid charging via CCS is 61 minutes, and we pretty much got bang on that. So I personally think that this car is absolutely fine. Another thing that I should mention is the throttling. So at 80%, we're down to about 36 kilowatts, and at 88%, it really drops off to around 16 kilowatt. That is very close, actually, to what the MG ZS EV now does after the 2021 BMS update. By the way, I have done a video on that, and you can have a look at it here. With respect to the range test, we are now looking at approximately 180 miles from 100% down to 0% theoretical range. We're also looking at a available 57.32 kilowatt hours versus what MG quotes, which is 57.7 kilowatt hours. Again, this car's battery pack has actually been bedded in, so that is a relatively reasonable figure. But I think that pretty much covers it. So if you found this video informative, please give it a like, or you like the video, please give it a like. Dislike it if you didn't. Please share this video to anyone who may have found this video informative or is considering purchasing an MG5 EV. Just one more thing, I'd like to thank Maple Garage again for lending me the car for 4 days for my testing. And in fact, actually, I would recommend them as a dealer of choice. I personally bought my MG ZS EV from them, and they've been absolutely brilliant when it comes to things like any things that have needed to have a look into. By the way, I will mention a couple things on the 30,000 mile update video, and as well as servicing and things like that. So be sure to check them out. But I think that pretty much covers it. So thank you for watching, and talk to you later.